sailors of HMCS Scotian as they observed Remembrance Day at the Sailors Memorial in Halifax. Today, the sailors especially remembered the 100,000 members of the Royal Canadian Naval Volunteer Reserve who formed the backbone of the country's naval forces during the Second World War Battle of the Atlantic. And as you know, this year marks the 50th anniversary of Allied victory in that campaign, the longest of the war.
Mm-hmm. War, youth's great adventure, and mankind's great tragedy. More than 1.5 million Canadians served overseas, and over 100,000 never returned to their loved ones.
And on this special Remembrance Day, all that is left of war are the memories. And for those left behind, those memories are still vivid. Memories of a falling husband, father, son, or sweetheart, and memories of what it was like for young men going off to war.
Mm-hmm. 3 years ago, we asked Bill Jessome if he would put into words what thoughts an 18-year-old had while boarding a troop ship that would carry him and hundreds like him off to war. Of all of Bill Jessome's special pieces, Pier 21 is the one most requested by Live at 5 viewers.
In the silence and stillness of a 1940s dawn, and while a nation sleeps in peace, ghostly faces move slowly down the long, narrow passageways of Pier 21. These were the welcoming doors that opened to Canada's immigrants. And Pier 21 was also the last place in Canada where its army passed through on its way to war. And beyond these doors and up the gangways, the chariots of war waited to carry Canada's youth off to foreign lands, off to war. If we're allowed a personal observation, Pier 21 has changed very little since I first marched through its doors so many years ago. It was, as I remember, a cold and rainy, windy morning. As I marched up the gangway, I smiled and I joked with my buddies, but deep inside there was a horrible feeling of the unknown. I remember turning in that early dawn, trying to see beyond Halifax to my own hometown, to my own family, wanting them to know that I was heading off to war. And I also had a terrible feeling that I would never come back, never again see the faces of my family or of the young girl I thought I could never get out of my mind. Those thoughts were probably shared by thousands of other young Canadians going off to war. Soldiers like Alan Moore of Dartmouth, who at 16 joined up. He too remembers Pier 21 and the unknown beyond the sea.
The year was 1942. I was all of 16 years of age at that time. And the month was December, which was very close to Christmas. And they marched us from the railroad station on through to the sheds here, the pier, Pier 21. And the Ile-de-France was berthed there, and we were all marched aboard and loaded to disembark to go overseas. I remember so well moving up on board and walking toward the bow of the Ile-de-France and looking across the harbor, and I could see, my eyes were good then too, I could see my mom out in the backyard and hanging her laundry on the line. And I said, oh, if only I could get home for just a few moments. But of course, we never did.
Even after so many years, when one thinks he understands what war is all about, he still has much to learn. And when he allows his mind to open that closed door to war, he cannot but remember painfully those who became his brothers in war and in death.
We had to depend on each other and rely on each other to win your objective or get to where you had to go. We're bringing back too many memories now, Bill. And I'm thinking about those fellows. I know where they're buried, and yeah, it's tough, really tough.
We have come a very long way from that dark time. The world and its people that were nearly destroyed have risen from the ashes to become united in peace. A country that was divided by war has become whole again. Was it worth it? And for all those Canadians who did not return through Pier 21 and to their loved ones, was their sacrifice worth it? Did they die in vain? The answer will not be found only on Remembrance Day, but only if today's generation understands what this country is all about, understands and appreciates it as a fading soldier does.
It's fascinating to hear those first-hand accounts of what it was like going off to war and what it was like fighting and for those who came back.
Indeed, powerful piece of television there. We should point out that that item aired 3 years ago on ATV, and it won an Atlantic Journalism Award and videography for Kevin MacDonald, edited by Robyn Hinton, and of course, the personal memories of Bill Jessome.
And it certainly has received a lot of requests from our Live at Five viewers to be replayed on air, and so we thought we'd honor Remembrance Day with playing it.
Special Remembrance Day edition of Live at Five continues in just a moment. Up next, Richard Zarowski with the Friday weather forecast, and Dan Vio with a finishing piece on this Remembrance Day. Back in a moment.